Okay, guys, let's move into the last section of the book before our first exam. Primarily, we're going to talk about inequalities here, but this is a review for some of you who haven't seen inequalities in a while or interval notation. I certainly expect some of you probably will just skip this part. But one of the issues I've seen as a teacher is you guys get confused on when to use parentheses or when to use brackets. So I want to review that for you all. All right, note that when I have brackets around 0 and 20, that means I'm including 0 and 20, okay? Whereas if I have parentheses around 0 and 20, that means that I'm getting infinitely close, but I'm not actually getting to 0 and I'm not actually getting to 20. In other words, I don't include 0 and 20. All right, I want to talk about the three representations of an inequality. All right, we have something called interval notation. All right, and that's when we use the brackets and parentheses. All right, so you can see here, like parentheses AB, all right, would just say that I'm in between A and B, but not actually equal to A and B. All right, and with interval notation, we can always graph the number line. All right, and so parentheses relate to open circles. Okay, meaning I can get infinitely close but can't include those endpoints. All right, whereas you notice here I have parentheses on the A, bracket on the B. All right, and so parentheses, I have the open circle on the A, but the bracket says I can get to B. So on my graph, that means I have the closed circle. Okay, and then lastly, I want to review set builder notation. Okay. Set builder notation is when we have the curly brackets. And I want to, let me take this one and read it to you in English, exactly what it says. The set of all x such that, so the set of all x such that x is between A and B, or we can say x is strictly between A and B. All right, or we can read it from left to right, A less than X less than B. All right, so again, the set of all X such that A is less than X less than B. All right, let me do this one. The set of all X such that A is less than X less than or equal to B. The set of all X such that A is less than or equal to X less than B. Okay, so that should give you an idea of how they read. Let me go down here to the bottom, read this one. The set of all X such that X is less than or equal to B. Okay, so hopefully after a few of those you get the idea of how set builder notation reads. All right, so again, you know, when it comes to interval notation, graphing, or set builder notation, you do need to know what they mean. Because if I ask you on the exam to represent your answer in interval notation, you need to know that that doesn't mean graphing on a number line. Similarly, if I ask you for set builder notation, you need to know that that does not mean interval notation. Okay, but you'll get plenty of practice in the homework. Okay, we want to express the interval in set builder notation and graph. All right, so what do I have here? I have, let me grab my pen again. All right, so we have a bracket on the negative 2 and a parentheses on the 5. All right, so what does that mean in set builder notation? The set of all x such that negative 2 less than or equal to x less than 5. Okay, and so what does that mean? That means I put a bracket, or we can do a closed circle. It doesn't matter, guys. Bracket or closed circle on the negative 2 and a parentheses or open circle on the 5. Again, closed circle, open circle. Oh, closed circle and a bracket are the same thing, and an open circle and a parentheses are the same thing in terms of graphing. All right, let's look at the second example. Parentheses on a negative 1 to this sideways 8. Well, what the heck's a sideways 8? That's our sign for infinity. So this is everything from negative 1 to infinity, not including negative 1. All right, and so what does that read in terms of the set builder notation? all x such that x greater than negative 1. Okay, so I go to my graph, I put a parenthesis or an open circle at negative 1, and I graph everything to the right, or everything greater than negative 1. Okay? Never, ever, ever put a bracket on an infinity. We should know this from our AT&T commercial, we can never get to infinity, there's always something bigger.